If you follow the channel, you know that RR Auction recently offered an Apollo guidance computer, which we helped identify as being the sibling of the very one we restored. You can imagine we followed the auction closely and actually bid on it. But as expected, it ended up into stratospheric, or should I say, orbital, territory close to $300,000 outside of our collective reach. But all was not lost, since our little group won several interesting items from this auction, which I hope to share with you in due time. Let's start with mine, and since you saw the title, you know at least what one of them is. Though unfortunately it's much smaller than an AGC, so you know I didn't get it. Okay. I can see a little bit of it. It's written in Russian. It is a clock from a Soyuz. Supposedly has been flown. And so we are going to have interesting circuits in there. So of course the Soyuz capsule is this famous round green thingy attached to that other famous pointy silver thingy. I'm actually crusty enough that I remember this very symbolic mission from my childhood, one of the few things I remember from the Apollo program. They probably never imagined that the Soyuz spacecraft would have such a long career and would become the only vehicle capable to get the American astronauts to the space station. Nice consolation prize from not having been able to get the AGC. So for those who are good in Russian, what does it all mean? R minute second, yeah, that's easy. Minute second, probably an event counter.
That's so. Astanov, this button here means stop.
Switches? Oh, those are nice. Those are nice switches. It has a... Oh, that's going to be interesting to interface too.
Oh, not one of those weird... So it has a lot of pins, like more than just power.
Little wires coming out. And this coming
those
out.
Those like tamper-proof screws.
It says Onboard Clock Soyuz TM Capsule. We think this is our minute second. Minute second. This is enter. This is start, operate, stop. This must be a chronometer.
Yeah.
Start.
Yeah, this is stop.
Stop, resets. It's start, stop, reset.
Right. And this is mission time, probably.
This is stopwatch. This is on. And here we don't quite know. This is a correction. This gets translated sometimes as frequency, sometimes as rate, sometimes as jaw. What were those two? So operate and maybe standby.
You don't know, it's
something
an
like that.
It's an initial. I saw it there somewhere in the text. As it was.
Can you? Oh, there it is. I saw it. All right. So. That is the from Steve Jurvetson, you say? So
yeah.
It looked like the analog predecessor has the same format, and it's also displayed on the same with the same tag as mine over there. And I saw the clock further down. Down, and there it is. This is my clock. So apparently the Soyuz panel used to have a beautiful analog clock on the upper left side, which was later swapped out for this digital clock, which took exactly the same space. And you can see another picture of it here.
Okay. Clock of current time is the...
Is what that FTB means.
Oh, it's Moscow time.
Right, and op is announcement time. Upcoming time. So in other words, you want it to tell you the time to some event like fire your retro at in 18 seconds and it counts down.
And it can be timed from an internal pulse generator or from the external
AMV
or
program
control 110.
Oh, it is controlled, stopped and started by external things.
Well, so you can, we can use it as an egg timer.
For your engine. Fire,
yeah.
And cut off.
Egg timer. To cook eggs.
Or you could sync it up with your Italian flip clock.
You've probably noticed through my videos that I have a budding collection of odd clocks in the lab, including a loud Italian Data 10, and the Soyuz clock is slated to join that display.
Here we go.
So should we open it up?
Yes.
Okay. All right. We buy it, we hack it. Since I paid for it, do I get to take it apart?
Of course.
Oh, it has been taken apart before, you can tell. That's holding pretty good.
So it might be your back connector plate there.
Yeah. Except it has wires coming through it that have been cut over here. So I don't know what that means. It does look like the back connector is the one that's holding the thing, but I don't have screws.
I think we've got the punch straightened out.
Okay, so the stuff that we thought might be coax is actually a hidden screw or a protected screw.
I was right. It's like tamper resistant screw.
Yeah, it's I'm having problems tampering with it.
Tampering on the backside of a Soyuz.
So indeed, the clock had tamper resistant screws. This is really odd. I can't imagine why you'd need this. Fortunately, they were not CuriousMarc resistant. Just screws covered with some epoxy in a cup. Fairly easy to take care of. So
that's a neat.
It's opening, so connector. There's definitely the little wire. It looks like an afterthought, is that somebody, for demonstration purposes, added wires and made them go through the screw holes. So these are, these have been added from the original, so maybe if you power that through this.
Someone wanted to animate it.
How do I get that through? There we go. Aha!
Uh-huh. Oh, that's nice.
Woohoo!
It actually has components.
Oh my, lots of them.
Wow, that, ooh, little.
Oh, it has little Apollo-like integrated circuits in it. Ooh, that's nice. Conformal coded. Well, this is way more complicated than I thought. So this is probably the very early version.
Well, that's
your work. What do you mean?
It's got like mystery ICs in many of them.
Yes, so it has your name on it.
So is that LED or electroluminescent display?
LEDs.
Okay, so it's not generating like hundreds of volts or
LEDs. But I have power supply, obviously. So it's pretty hard to see what's in there. But you see.
No, it's 10.
ICs? ICs in flat packs, there's one
what's
here.
What's the square?
Oh, that's. There's an interesting thing here. There's a selector for frequency.
No, we think that's an inductor.
Just sockets for the inductors here.
So we can just hook power up to those wires and crank up the power until we see something on the display.
Or something smokes.
Yeah. 50-50.
So you think it's going to be 5 volts DTL? It looks like early RTL.
Like these wiring harnesses. It's just like boards put in and then the wire is soldered in and it never comes apart.
Well, there's screws all over the place here, so you can definitely.
You can just splay them out, but you can't detach them.
Oh, and the screws have been locked in epoxy. But it's single layer, no, two layers PCBs.
So what's the date on this?
Well, it says 11-11-83. 11-11-83. 8-3-2. This one says 15-11-83. Okay, so if we want to take the thing further apart, wow, so look, there's a grounding that's not going to come up with it. Ah, yeah, it might come up this way.
Yeah.
Let me try that.
Oh. Kerosene liquid oxygen, isn't it?
Okay, guys, it opens up.
Ooh.
Ah, oh.
Ooh, that's nice.
Not much gold, eh? This one looks like it was a rework. This one is definitely surface mount. Not through hole. This looks so much more ancient than 83. So let's see. This is what they fly to the ISS.
Yeah, it looks.
So 83 is over here.
It looks like about 1970 from I had to put a date on.
Right. Yeah, this really have IC, but no, it's primitive ICs.
The color of the boards too, the substrates.
It looks like SMS cards.
And then this is 83 too.
Random burnt parts.
This is 84. This has an 84 data on it. This big transistor. This is 84 right here.
So I wonder if we can find a data book for any of these ICs.
This is from the picture we just took.
This is yours, and then this is the same part on eBay.
How did you find it? Just entered a number?
Yeah. $6.
What does it do?
It's a voltage regulator, adjustable 3 to 12 volts.
And I spent a good hour extracting just a few screws. The ICs may look old for their build date, but the screws are absolutely first class. Alright. Here we go. Ooh! Ah, I have your crystal! What do you think?
That definitely looks like a crystal.
And then you have the drivers for the LEDs. Alright.
Does that look like that?
Oh, yeah! Right, so it opens up like a book. Look at that. That's beautiful. And look at how much rework there is on something that they must have been made since the 70s, right? And there's like one, two, three wires.
Someone said, make it the same.
Yeah, it looks like they didn't revise their PCB to clean it up, right? Just kept doing the same thing forever.
Did this one actually go into space?
That's how it's advertised on the auction, whether it really did, go figure. But it says it's flown.
It's got dots on the chip, so at least they look like they're
super. It was certainly assembled. It was super hard to take apart.
Flown, right? Maybe they sent it here airmail.
look at that good one, right? They had
I'm less enthusiastic about going on a Soyuz rocket now.
Ooh. That's famous words, man. Well, it's well built.
Well, they may have random budge wires running around, but at least the screws are in tightly.
Oh, the one that were really difficult, the one on the side, my goodness. Those were super hard.
I was thinking about this module over lunch and figured I'd come back and things would make sense.
Did
it's like, no, it's just as bizarre as I
it, it's just horrendously complicated for a clock.
And so they got like a maybe all right. Triple the boost needs.
Here are. Ooh, some have been replaced. They have been.
Those look very much like normal 7-segment displays.
Yeah, but there's some that have had repairs.
Yeah.
Okay. Look at how much variation there is between each of them.
Huh? Oh, this one looks like it's peeling.
Yeah, so this one has been reworked and re-glued. It's not looking too good. Here is my clock. All disassembled. with the very uneven LEDs. They look like made by amateurs. The driver board, the logic board, we think that's the oscillator. Plenty of logic board. What does that do? The power supply. And you're back. Should I put it back together, or you want to leave it like this so we can separate some more board and we can look at it more tomorrow or another day?
Yeah, I'd say leave it open because there's more study to be done here.